For the final and most important True Colors experience, we took over New York City. We put the clues up at Times Square every couple of hours, starting at 10 a.m., and sent them to separate locations to find the logo, so it was a little bit more of a challenge.
She just screamed into the phone, Washington Square Park, and I just ran to find the Z symbol.
I sprinted from Grand Central.
We just took a pedicab, a taxi.
I didn't make it to the Central Park, but you know, I didn't give up. Hard work finally paid off.
I'm sorry, I can't speak. I am out of breath.
The first 12 people at each location were then invited to come and meet me at the top of the Empire State Building for the final listening party.
Made it. Number 7.
I'm number 15. I'm like actually shaking.
It's crazy.
I'm so excited.
When I think of New York City, I think of a city that never sleeps, something historical and something very international. You can find any type of music in New York, you can find any type of club, there's everything in New York. True Colors is that type of album that has every sort of song and every type of emotion.
Hello everyone!
At first, we listened to the entire album the way it was structured from top to bottom. We put a stream up on the screen so people could see the Empire State Building from outside and how the lights were colored and synced to the music. And being in the building, you could look outside the window and you could see the reflection of the lights. You felt that you were inside it and you could see it from outside, which was just really crazy. Didn't tell the fans was that at the very end of this night I would perform True Colors live for the very first time ever. It felt incredible and emotional to see the Empire State Building play with us.
Loved you so much.
He turned the Empire State upside down.
I don't even know what to think.
Exactly.